के लेट्स स्टार्ट हैंड्स इन ध्यान मुद्रा सिट स्ट्रेट क्लोज द आईज थ्रू द ओपनिंग प्रेयर सहनावतु सहनो भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः. Keep the eyes closed, join hands at back of the body and bow forward to the Mother Supreme Earth. Inhale, come back up, rub the palms against each other and place the warm hands over the eyes and face. Open and close eyes few times behind the palms. Slide the hands down and very gently open the eyes. Good morning, everybody. Jai Shri Krishna. Let's start the warm up. Waist and above. So 370 bones in human body. Not necessary all the time. From birth to death, it gradually reduces. Then count goes probably close to 315 or 360 or so. And there are joints, about 360 joints. So we will try to cover as many as body parts join during the warm-ups. And roll the fist forward few times. And backward. And swing. Fold at elbows. Inhale when elbows go up. Exhale when hands go down. Spread the fingers on the floor. Connect them together on the shoulders. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Connect the mind and body through breathing. So breathe going to become a bridge between those two. Hold all the fingers together, rotate the elbows, so elbow touch once in front, it's rotation, and back of the palms touch once when we bring the elbows up. You can do breath coordination and reverse. And relax. Hands sideways. Turn the palms 90 degree up. Sit straight. So trunk should not move, trunk or head. Just we are circling the palms around shoulders. So make sure we are pushing the palms at back as well. So all four directions, it should be a perfect circle. If somebody looking from the side, they will see the perfect circle around the shoulder. And two times reverse. And release. Now grab the one arm, the upper arm, and circling the lower arm, and few times reverse. And let the wrist joints and the fingers be completely relaxed. And the other hand. So we are using just the elbow joint. So upper arm completely still. Okay. Inhale, raise both hands up. Exhale, fully turn towards right side, right palm at the back. Left palm behind the right knee, push the knee forward, turn back. Inhale up, exhale on the other side. Try to keep trunk as vertical as possible. Align the chin with the shoulders at the back. Inhale up, exhale. So we are going both the sides one by one. Inhale up. Little bit faster, shoulders away from the ear. Deeply inhale, deeply exhale, up again. And again, other side, and hold. Fully exhale, hold the pose. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale up. And the other side. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, come back. Interlock the palms of the fingers. Place the palms over the forehead. Deeply inhale, hold the breath. Press the palm and head against each other. Release the breath, release the palms. And from the back, inhale. Press the elbows towards back and let the chest expand. Again, front and back one more time. And sideways. So this will release the tensions around neck and shoulder region. Both palms on the knees. Inhale, look up, all the way up, and expand the thoracic region. Feel the extension at the throat. Exhale, bring the head down, chin all the way to the chest while we fully exhale. Inhale one more time, go up. The trunk and shoulder blades remain completely still. Exhale, bring the head down. Now inhale, turn the head towards the right side. Look up and continue going in circular fashion from the up. Start exhalation, turn the head towards left and bring it down. Inhale from the right again, second circle. And exhale from the left. And then two circles from left to right. Deeply breathe in, deeply breathe out. should do steady, gentle movement. Now bring the neck straight. Look at the level of the eyes. Inhale without moving the shoulders. Just turn the head towards right as we exhale. Align chin with the right shoulder. Look at the sideways Parshvadrashti as far as possible. Hold 3 to 5 seconds, then inhale and slowly come, bring the head back to center. And as we exhale, continue turning towards left, all the way left. Feel the stretch at the neck region. And inhale, come back to center. One more time, right and left. And back to center and relax. Let's sit in L shape, Dandasana. Pull the toes towards the body and hold it for a few seconds. And make sure the trunk is completely vertical. So it's going to make complete L shape, legs and trunk. Now squeeze and release all the toes. Then push them together forward and bring them back. Inhale when you push them forward. Exhale when you bring them back. Make sure the knees will remain straight, completely straight. Then few times alternate. And make a circle. So the toes circling around the heels. Gonna warm up the ankle joints. Increase the blood circulation. Each of the body parts we utilize in a warm-up process, and that increase the flexibility. And few times reverse. Now lift the right leg up, and you can either hold it with both the hands, or you can even bring it a little bit up and grab the opposite elbows. Inhale, raise the leg up fully. Exhale, bend it down. Inhale up. Exhale, bend it down, and try to relax and straighten the trunk. Inhale up, toes stretch out, exhale down, and then circle, just the lower leg. And few times reverse. Then straighten the leg. You can just with both hands grab at the ankles, or you can go even further at the heel, or if it is more comfortable to grab the foot near the toes and pull it up to the point that far you can have your knee straight. Once you notice that knee is bending, then don't pull it forward and hold it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Try to bring head to the knee and bend the leg, bring the foot on the left leg, interlock the fingers and use the right palm to push the right knee down. create some flexibility. And then just use the palm and bring knee to the chin. Inhale, when you push knee to the floor, hold it for a couple of seconds. And then exhale, bring it to the chin. Two more times on right side. This will open up the hip joint, increase the blood circulation into the region, pelvis region. Straighten the leg slowly and lift the left leg up. One of the two ways, you can just hold it up. Trunk, try to relax and straighten. And inhale, raise it up, the leg. Exhale, bring the leg down. And circle. Okay, then straighten the leg, grab it at the ankle, heel, or at the foot. Try to keep the leg straight and hold it up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And one time, try to bring head closer to the knee. And bend the leg, put the left foot somewhere midpoint on the right leg. Interlock the fingers and use the left palm to push the left knee down a few times. And then just use the palm and try to bring knee to the chin. Inhale when you push it down. Hold it for a couple of seconds on the floor, and then exhale, bring the knee to the chin. 4 to 5 times total. Okay. After that, let bend at both the knees. Bring feet together, interlock the fingers, place them over the toes. So first, you can also try to bring the knees all the way up and all the way down, and then speed up. Titli Asana, butterfly pose. See if you can bring the knees all the way to the floor. Roll side by side, bring the body closer to the heels. From Titli Asana, we will do Bhadrasana or Bhadrasana. Sit straight, keep pushing the knees to the floor, spine erect. You can close the eyes, deeply inhale, hold the breath in lower abdomen. Hold at least 5 to 7 seconds. During that time, make sure we are keep pressing the knees down and trunk straight. And observe, witness the extra stretch we feel in pelvis area, hip joints. Okay, and last round of breath. And once you complete, when you breathe out, then roll the body side by side and bring the body a little bit away from the heels. Next, we will do Baddha Konasana. Inhale, look up, expand the chest, shoulders away from the ear. Fully exhale, bend from the lower back. Try to keep head and trunk in one line. So keep pushing the trunk instead of head. So when you can no longer press the trunk even further down, that point you can drop the head down. And see if you're able to bring the forehead to the feet. Let's do one more time. You can use the elbows to push the shin bone back and bring the body forward and all the way down. Okay. Sit in a cross-legged posture. We will do Bhastrika Pranayama. You can just make a Svastikasana, Padmasana, Ardha Padmasana, whatever cross-legged posture you're comfortable with. First fingertip and thumb tip together. Sit straight, shoulders relaxed. Deeply inhale, deeply exhale. Keep the eyes closed and 100% awareness on breathing only. So cold air entering at the nostril and feel some cold sensation. When we breathe out, hot air exiting at the nostril point, feel some warm sensation. So keep on going, noticing those sensations and also breathing related movements, nothing else. But do deep breath in and deep breath out. No need to use any force. Okay, breathe normal. Open the eyes. So next we will do Surya Nadi Pranayama. Bring the right hand up. Roll first two fingers into root of thumb. Surya Nadi Pranayama. So we're going to inhale from right and exhale from right. Right and right only. You can use ring fingertip to continuously block the left nostril. So deeply inhale from right and deeply exhale from right. Other hands can be in Dhyan Mudra, but the right elbow should be up sideways at the level of the shoulder. Okay, conclude when you breathe out from right. This is very good for warming up the body. Okay, next we will do Kapalbhati. So this actively we're gonna exhale forcefully and let some breath come in and keep on going like once per second or so. We will do 50 to 60, and if you have to stop in between, you can just stop. Forcefully breathe out. We can keep hands in Vayu Mudra. Roll first fingertips into root of thumbs. Kapalbhati. So we're gonna inhale and try to inhale in lower abdomen and exhale forcefully. Once you complete, just sit completely still, open the palms towards the ceiling, close the eyes, feel the vibrations. Okay, relax. Now bring the right hand forward. Interlock with left hand fingers such a way that so right thumb will stay up and left first finger and left thumb will surround the right thumb and hold it up straight. Close the eyes, sit straight, shoulders relaxed, keep awareness at the Nabhi Chakra, solar plexus. And relax. Inhale, raise both hands up. Exhale, bring one palm on the side and let the elbow go on the floor. Exhale fully. Don't try to lift. Don't try to let any of the knees go up. Look at the ceiling and keep pressing the other arm down. And try to keep the other elbow straight. Inhale, go up. So we are bending sideways. Full stretch. One more time. Next, we'll do Shankh Mudra. Again, bring the right hand forward. Keep the right thumb up. With left hand, just make a fist and grab the right thumb into the fist. So now the left thumb is up. Now pull the right all fingers together. So connect right first finger into the left thumb, both tip together, And remaining three right fingers will go back of the left palm. So if we look from the front, all we can see is left four fingers folded and left thumb and right first finger tipped together. So it looks like scones. And hold it up straight and keep awareness, close the eyes and keep awareness into the throat area, the thoracic region. Inhale, exhale, normal. You can even hold at the elbows, no need to hold it straight, stretch. So you can just bring the mudra closer to the face. Keep awareness at throat area. And release. That was Shankh Mudra. Scones pose very good for thoracic related issues. Extend the legs. Upavishta Konasan. Inhale, raise hand up. Look at the ceiling. Keeping the knees straight, bend from the lower back. And push the trunk forward and down. See if you grab big toes or the foot. Then you can push the trunk down without curving the back. Inhale, come back up. Look up. And do one more time. Fully exhale and grab the feet either from the top or sideways or whatever, how far as much as you can go. Keep pressing the trunk even further down. Inhale, come back up. Now turn towards one leg, look up, fully exhale and bend forward. With both hands equally, grab the foot and bring the head to the knee. Inhale, come up and turn towards the other leg. Exhale, bend forward. Inhale, come back up and fold the right leg, bring the right heel at the perineum, fully exhale, look up and turn the body, turn the shoulder blade towards the left leg, Janu Sirsasana, fully exhale, bend forward and try to bring forehead to the left knee. Inhale, come back up. One more time, same side. Tuck the stomach in this time. Bend forward. All the way down. And make the navel lock. Uddiyana Bandha. Inhale, come back up. That was almost 20 seconds. And other side. come back up, second time with longer duration. Lock the navel. Inhale, come back up. Then both legs together, feet together. Inhale, look up. Raise hands up. Even you can lean slightly back. Expand the chest. Exhale fully and bend from the lower back. And grab the feet. Continue pushing the trunk forward. And further bend down. You can lock the navel, apply the Uddiyan Bandha. Inhale, come back up. One more time. Deeply inhale while up. And deeply exhale as we go down.
And apply the Uddiyan Bandha and keep pressing head down.
Inhale, come back up and we will do complementary pose. You can go halfway if you are able to do reverse plank fully. Inhale, push the body up and toes on the floor. So heels and toes on the floor. The whole body up, drop the head at back. And if you are able to go in this pose fully, you can fold elbows and keep the elbows on the floor, drop the head at the back, and you can lift the lower back up. And very slowly come back down, back to Dandasana. Make sure the knees are straight. With left hand, use the left first two fingers. Grab the left toe, bend forward a little bit. Grab the left toe inside out. And bend at the right knee. We will do Akarna Dhanurasana. With the right hand, grab the right ankle. And while holding the left toe with the left hand, bringing the right foot at the right ear. And try to close the ear. And hold it. Akarna Dhanurasana. And on the other side. So go step by step. And even if you go halfway, that's fine. Then keep that as a homework. કર્ણ ધનુરાસન કર્ણ ઉપરથી મને યાદ આવ્યું કે આપણે પાર્થનું પેલું ગુજરાતીમાં કહેતા ને અર્જુનને કે પાર્થને કહો ચડાવે બાણ હવે યુદ્ધ એ જ કલ્યાણ તો આપણું ન્યુ સ્લોગન છે કે પાર્થને કહો પાથરે મેટ પાર્થને કહો પાથરે મેટ હવે તો યોગ એ જ કલ્યાણ ઓકે So next, fold the right leg, bring the right foot at the left knee, exhale, bring the right hand forward, and make sure the triceps is going well beyond the knee. So that way we will be able to bend the hand outer way, and bring the other hand from the back of the body. We are doing Marichi Asan. Connect both the hands together. Once you make connection, try to straighten the trunk, look straight. Hold the pose for a few seconds. And then fully exhale. Do the Uddiyana Bandha, the lock the navel, and try to bring the head closer to the left knee. As far as you can go. And inhale, come back up. Now release the hands. Keep the leg as is. And while in this pose, try to bring foot closer to the knee. And we will do Vakrasana here. In Vakrasana, the right palm will go at the back of the body. You can do like intermediate position. Exhale, fully look back. Or you can just even push the knees further towards the left side. And with the left hand, you can grab the left knee. And then you can twist back. Feel the full twist at the navel area, the lower abdomen. Okay. Inhale, come back. And the Marichi Asana on the other side. So during Marichi Asana, we try to keep the foot few inches away from the knee. So that way there is a better chance that we should be able to connect the hands. So look straight. And then try to bend down with the Uddiyana Bandha. And Vakrasana. So during Vakrasana, we can bring foot closer to the knee. Okay, inhale, come back. Next, our favorite one, Gomukhasana, cow face pose. Both knees on top of each other, align them together. So if it goes straight up because of some flexibility issue, try to adjust the legs a little bit and try to bring them as close as possible. So whichever knee is up, that side the hand will go from the top and back, the other hand will go directly at the back and connect them together. And once you make connection, straighten the trunk, head and neck, and look at the level of eyes, and then you can close the eyes and hold in a pose. You can scan the whole body from top to bottom. There are multiple body parts and joints are activated. And just scan the body quickly, feel that which body part has what kind of sensation or any pain or any relaxation. And slowly transition to the other side. You can always use the hands to correct the posture, to get into the pose. That stage is called prep. So if anybody have trouble connecting the hands at back of the body, you can use strap, yoga strap, any belt, napkin or any kind of thing. But goal is to gradually gain the flexibility to bring the hands closer and closer and connect them. Okay, over here, so whichever knee is up currently, that leg, bring it even further up, bring the foot slightly outward of the knee. We are doing Ardha Matsyendrasana. So whichever leg is up, that side hand will go back of the body. Inhale, raise the other hand up. Exhale, you can go halfway. So you can go this position, look at the sideways, or you can twist back, or at maximum flexibility, you can just grab the ankle and then twist and look back. Align chin with the shoulder at the back and try to push the palms on the floor in order to bring the trunk in a vertical posture, as vertical as possible. Ardha Matsyendrasana, and switch to the other side. So this is combination of previous two postures, Vakrasana and Gomukhasana. Okay, release the hands, come back, and let's go into Vajrasana. For a few seconds, just relax. Make sure our trunk is completely straight, vertical. So our heels getting load, vertical load, not angle load. And try to do Parsva Vajrasana. So both, again, both feet are together, but we are bringing the heels closer at our, the hips. You can use the palm to straighten the body at first. Once we are completely in a posture, then very slowly let the hands go. And hold the posture, feel the stretch in waist area. And see if your head, neck and trunk in straight line. And then let's switch to the other side. So what is this called? Parsva means side. So Parsva Vajrasana. Okay, come back to center, and that reminds me that I need to unlock, so you guys can go unmute when it needed. Okay, now let's do Virasana for a few seconds. Both heels are on a side, and our glute muscles, our sitting bones, straight resting on the floor, only if you are able to. And over here also we can do so many kind of things in this posture also. We can just bring the shoulder rotation. So arm is going along with the shoulder. We are not doing anything with the arms. We can do rivers. We're not going to stay longer in Virasan pose because we are not used to do that for so long. And next, we will do Mandukasan. So sit in a standard Vajrasan pose. Sit on the heels. Bring both hands forward. Make tight fist, thumbs inside. And we're going to put the top of the fist slightly above the navel. So deeply inhale, hold the breath in lower abdomen. And then put the top of the fist slightly over the navel. Not at the navel, but slightly over the navel. Forcefully exhale.
Without leaving the heels, bring the trunk all the way down. And drop the head completely. And that point at the end, tilt the head slightly up. So that way it will give us full pressure
at the solar plexus. Okay, inhale, come back up. We'll do one more time. Okay, come back and let's go complementary pose, Supta Vajrasan or Supayan Vajrasan. Palms at the back to support the body and very slowly get back. If you want to go halfway, just bring the elbows on the floor, drop the head at the back, knees will be grounded, but if you have flexibility, you can just push the palms forward and let the whole trunk and head completely go on the floor while keeping the knees grounded. You can even raise both hands up, place them over the thighs. You can close the eyes, you can scan the whole body in 2 seconds from head to toe. Some body parts may be requesting you to come out of the pose. Some body parts may be saying that, okay, this is great, just stay. But don't worry about if you feel any pain or anything. Just assume this is nothing but a sensation, it's not a pain. And whenever you want to come out of the pose, just grab ankles, push the elbows on the floor, and bring the body up back to Vajrasan or diamond pose or thunderbolt pose. And if you find lock yourself in a posture, let's say if you are here, if you have just started doing this posture and somehow you are unable to come out of the pose, just you can roll down left or right, doesn't matter, just in order to come out the pose. That's a final resort, but try to come back up. That's the best way. But if in case of emergency, you can just roll your body towards the sides. Let's do a child pose. Keep the knees separated far apart in order to accommodate our trunk. Look up. Deeply inhale, exhale, bend from the lower back and land the palms on the floor and then slide the palms even further forward as we bring our forehead on the floor or chest and chin on the floor. Inhale, exhale deeply. Continue sitting on the heels, so heels and hips remain touched. Relax the whole body, especially the lower back and shoulders. Deeply inhale, deeply exhale. And very slowly walk the hands little bit, little by little, back to the body and let the head and trunk rise itself. So when we do this way, we notice our weight is shifting right to left to right as we go, like one hand at a time, bringing it back. So notice that too. And we will go half camel pose today. So knees and feet separated, same as the hip joints, hip width, or the shoulder length. Bring both palms at the hip joints, fingers pointing down. Roll the shoulders back. Inhale, bend backward. Drop the head at the back. Keep pushing elbows closer to each other and keep pushing the pelvis forward. So there are three things. As I do countdown, you're going to be apply more and more force. Keep pushing pelvis forward. Keep pressing the elbows towards each other and keep bending down. Keep dropping the head at the back. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Bring the hands down. Straighten the body. Okay. And bring both palms on the floor. And back on the heels, bring both palms on the side, just align them with the feet, keep the knees separated, inhale, exhale fully, and try to bring the forehead on the floor between the knees, fully bend down, and relax the lower back, shoulders, arms. And feel the full relax. You can deep breathe in, deep breathe out here. Okay, inhale, come back up and into tabletop pose. So make sure the wrists are vertically under the shoulders and knees vertically under the hip joints. And look straight. Let's do cat and cow pose. Inhale, look up. Push even the lower back up as well. Try to make the spine downward arch. Exhale fully. Look at the navel. And try to make the spine upward arch. Do few more times. Inhale fully, look up, exhale, and do with your own pace. Okay, and complete the round. Then look straight. Inhale, exhale, normal. With next inhalation, kick the right leg back and hold it parallel to the floor. And look at here, the left knee is bent at 90 degree and the arms are vertical. Now with next inhalation, bend the right knee at 90 degree and don't drop the knee. Need to hold it up. So everything will be cut and straight kind of thing. And you can turn back and make sure the leg is not leaned towards one side. And the right knee will be same level as the hip joint. And look straight forward. Inhale, exhale, normal. Now keep the legs as is. Bring the left hand up. And bring it back. With left hand, grab the right ankle. And pull the right leg up. Keep looking straight. And try to maintain the balance. Keep pushing the right leg up. And with the hand, you can even pull as high as it can go. And relax. Try to bring the left knee, right knee on the floor, the left palm on the floor. Inhale, exhale, normal. With next inhalation, kick the left leg back at the level of the floor, parallel to the floor. And look straight. Relax the lower back. With next inhalation, bend at the left knee, 90 degree. And without dropping the knee down, keep the leg, the lower leg straight up. You can even turn around and look at your leg just to make sure it's not leaning towards any of the direction. This is tiger pose. It's a very good posture for the people who have back pain. Relax the lower back while holding the legs and hands in the pose. Now slowly lift the right hand up and grab the left ankle. And try to pull the left leg up. You can do use two forces. You can push the leg up. At the same time, with the hand, you can pull it up, even further up. And continue looking the forward. And try to bring the knees on the floor, palms on the floor, back to tabletop pose. So if you guys notice that, okay, stay in a pose and inhale, exhale normal and relax a little bit. So when I was holding my leg up, right? I don't know where my ankle is, right? It could be here, anywhere. But as soon as I try to bring my hand here, it's just great. Hand knows that already, where is my ankle? Or it could be anywhere, right? Without looking. So how that happens? That's the proprioception in our body. Like, you know, it's a pool of sensors everywhere. So it knows exactly of the each of the body parts, their locations, and all of the things. Plus it has pressure sensors and everything. So, okay, from here we can just, what time it is? 8:35. Okay, let's stand up. So proprioception notices, registers everything. If I close my eyes, and if I lift my hand this way or slightly this angle or this angle, anywhere, so our brain knows where each of the body part is. So if I close my eyes, and if my hand is here, and if I try to grab the fingers with the other hand, it automatically straight lands on that. It doesn't have to go like this, like blind people. No, it just goes right there. Because body has all latest GPS technology. But GPS have limitation. It's just only the positioning. And here it does positioning, has a pressure, all kind of sensation. Proprioception. Okay, both feet together. Inhale, go into Tadasana, interlock the fingers, palms upside down. Push the palms toward the ceiling. Heels up. Exhale, bring the palms on head and heels down. Inhale, go up, heels up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. And last round, we're going to hold posture up. And we're going to be pushing the palms toward the ceiling. The whole body and arms stretch up. And release. Now let's walk on the toes. Make two circles around here, around the mat. And two circles, walk on the heels. And what it does? Can anybody type?
It activates our lymphatic system, I guess.
Lymphatic. And paralympic, yes. So, legs spread far apart. Now, spread the hands sideways. Inhale, exhale, speedy. And what we're gonna do is, look, exhale, as soon as, because our hand comes here and immediately goes back, right? So before it goes back, we're just going to lock it with the other hand, right? So what we'll do is inhale, exhale, and then continue pressing the body, twisting towards back. So we are doing Kati Chakrasana along with the other things. So inhale, come back, straight, and other side. Twist all the way back. Inhale. Even keep on pressing the hands to go even further on the back. And one more time, both sides. The other arm will remain straight, and you would be pointing, gazing at the fingers. And you are following that arm, that hand. Okay. Inhale, raise the one arm up. Exhale, bend sideways. And keep looking toward the ceiling, Trikonasana. Because if we don't look up, we probably go out of the plane. We go like this way, right? But that's not good. So keep looking up, so our body will remain in one plane. Inhale, come back. And the other side. Okay, one more time. Okay, both sides. Let's do Surya Namaskar, because Surya Namaskar itself is a warm-up. It doesn't need any other preps, and we had a lot already preparation done. Let's see. So we'll do slower version. So we're going to stay longer in a pause and try to do the perfect pause and try to stay longer. Sound good?
Hiranyagarbhaya Namaha.
Om Hiranyagarbhaya Namaha.
Five Surya Namaskar, 60 poses. So actually doing Surya Namaskar, we feel that we had a massage. That kind of relaxation our body parts feel. Okay, let's sit down in a Malasan. And we can even do in a pranam and kick the knees out. But make sure the heels and toes flat on the... Heels and feet. Heels and toes flat on the floor. Okay. And we can just bring one hand. The bicep push the knees out and other hand raise it up in the air toward the ceiling and look at the palm up in the air. Even go a little further back and up. And feel the pull twist at the lower and mid trunk and on the other side. First, it's even try to push the palms outward as far as possible on the floor. So here we should be able to bring our both arms in a straight line and look up toward the ceiling through the palm. Okay. So આપણે ગઈકાલે અનાઉન્સ કર્યું હતું આપણા સેશનમાં કે આપણું યોગા ગ્રુપનું ફર્સ્ટ ઇયર થાય છે, એટલે આવતા સેટરડે આપણે એક ઇવેન્ટ રાખીએ છીએ, હોળીના થીમ ઉપર રાખીએ છીએ, બધા હોળીને રિલેટેડ સોંગ્સ ને એવું બધું, અને સ્મિતાબેન, ડૉક્ટર સ્મિતાબેન, ડૉક્ટર તરુણભાઈ સ્પોન્સર કરી છે ઇવેન્ટ. જૂનાગઢથી આપણે એક મ્યુઝિકલ ગ્રુપ બુક કર્યું છે અને this that event is from our group, so I hope everyone will connect. You can bring your other families and enjoy, and we're going to be wearing some kind of colorful clothes, some holy gear. અને આજનો જે દર સન્ડે ની મ્યુઝિકલ ઇવેન્ટ હોય છે એ આજે છે જ, પાછી આજે 10:30 એ છે, એટલે એ મધુભાઈ પરીખ વાળું ગ્રુપ નું, એ તો આપણે ઓલરેડી આ ગ્રુપ માં પોસ્ટર મૂક્યું છે, એટલે એમાં જે ફ્રી હોય જોઈન્ટ થવું હોય, અને આપણું આ જે પોસ્ટર છે સ્મિતાબેન વાળું એ ત્યાં રેડી કરીએ છીએ, એ પછી ગ્રુપમાં મૂકશું. લેટ્સ સ્ટેન્ડ ઇન વૃક્ષાસન ટ્રી પોઝ. યુ કેન ગો હાફ વે, લાઈક મેક અ pranam. If you have a little balancing issue and if you are stable in the intermediate pose, then you can even raise both hands up as well. And there is even advanced version of this is in the same pose you can close the eyes, but don't try as a beginner, and make sure there is nothing around you that even if you fell down and you get hurt, so do it very carefully if you want to try it. And switch to the other side. Somebody is holding treadmill. That's okay. 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 Let's fold the right leg. And bring the right hand at back of the body and try to grab the right foot or right ankle. And see if we can bend forward. And lift the head up and the left knee would be remain completely straight. Okay, and if you are not successful, then try the other side.
Okay.
Let's get down on the floor. It's 8:57. We're gonna lay down on a stomach. I hope everyone completed that posture. Good. And just lay down in a Makarasana for a few seconds. Fully relax and feel the sensation of the relaxation. Legs together, extend both hands over the head. With next inhalation, raise the hands, head, chest, chin up, and pull legs up, thighs over the floor, and hold them up. Just the stomach, pelvis area stays on the floor. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And back to Makarasana. Relax in a Makarasana. Don't hold any muscles, any body parts. Just full relax. Now just hold both elbows. So the lower arm will be on the floor, both legs together, lift the head, chest, chin up. So the elbows bent at 90 degrees. So the upper arm is vertical to the floor. And both arms are parallel to each other. Bend at both the knees. Try to bring the feet closer to the closer to the hip joint. Cross them and exhale. Turn towards one side, look at the feet. Try to bend as much as you can. Inhale, come back straight. Turn the legs and turn toward the other side. Look at the feet. One more time, cross the legs other way. Fully exhale. And also try to keep the leg pulling towards the hip joints. And on the other side. Yep. And bring both the palms under the chin, elbows on the floor, just like the kids watching TV. When we were kid, I don't think we had that luxury to watch TV, but if you remember, our kids did all the time this. You can do one leg at a time, hit the own butt, or you can do both legs together. And that time, try to relax the lower back and do this. Okay. And lay down in a Makarasana. Relax for a few seconds. Both legs separate. The toes pointing out. So whatever we did earlier, the kicking the legs, those is also very good for back pain, relieving any back related issues. Now bring the palms under the thighs. We will do Ardha Shalabhasana. Lift the one leg up, keeping the knee straight, toes pointing out, bend the other leg and put the foot over the straight leg in order to support it. Relax the lower back, chin, shoulder blade, chest flat on the floor. And normal breath in and out. Very slowly bring the legs back to the floor and switch to the other side. If you relax the lower back, and you will see the big difference. And make sure the body is not turning toward one side, so both shoulders should be on the floor. And both legs back on the floor, turn around, and lay down on the back. In about a couple of minutes, we'll be doing Yog Nidra. Ustikasana, stick pose. Extend both hands over the head. Push the toes outward. Feel the full stretch from fingers to the toes. And feel that your body is extending, getting extended at least a few inches. Keep pushing them out. Toes and fingers in opposite direction. Stretch and hold it. And release. Now bring both hands side of the body. And breathe in and out normal. You can relax in Shavasana for a few seconds. Both legs together, bend at the knees, lift the feet up, so knees closer to the chest, and bring both the hands up, back of the palms touching each other, and bring them between the feet, and try to grab the feet inside out, left to left, right to right. And even pull the legs down. So the upper leg is pressing the chest area. Bring it down and hold it. We can just roll a little bit side by side, not too much, to massage the back and the spine. And release. Straighten the legs, both palms on the side of the body. So next we'll do Navkasana. Lift the leg and trunk just 30 degrees over the floor. Raise the hands up. Look the toes through the fingers. Very slowly bring the body back to the floor and lay down in Shavasana. Hands away from the body, palms facing up, fingers semi-closed. Feet apart, 2 to 3 feet, toes pointing out. Bring both legs together, both palms, side of the body. Now, bend at the right knee,
and bring the right foot slightly outward of the left knee. We are doing Kattipinda Mardanasana. Lift the left palm up and put it over the right knee. Press the right knee towards left and hold it. Hold it on the floor. And extend the right hand perpendicular to the body on the right side. And turn the head towards right. So right knee is on the left side on the floor and head is looking toward the right palm, which is on the floor on right side. And the left leg remains straight. So left leg and trunk will make one straight line. Inhale, come back to the center. Straighten the right leg and bend the left knee. And same thing on the opposite side. So don't turn the head yet. First, press the knee down to the floor, all the way to the floor. And once it is completely touched the floor, that point we are twisting. So we can look on the opposite side. This is also a variation of the Markatasana. Natarajasana, Markatasana, Kattipinda Mardanasana. So all of them goes into same category. We can just call them different variations. Okay, inhale, come back. Next we will do bicycling. Bring the palms side of the body to support the body. Hold both the legs. Lift them up. Then start pedaling. Biggest pedal. 10 pedal forward and 10 pedal backward. And each time when foot goes away from the body, that point toes stretch outward. And otherwise you can just bring them, press them back towards the body. And that is just for the extra stretch. And each time you need to straighten the legs completely straight. And then you need to fold it back. Then 10 times reverse. Okay, and relax in a Shavasana, full relax, close the eyes, you should be able to hear your own heartbeat. Okay, now let's do Uttan Padasana or the Ardha Halasana. So this is not an inversion, so everybody can do this. Lift both legs up. Inhale fully while keeping the legs up. Exhale, lower the leg down to 10 degrees. Keeping the knees straight, again inhale, lift them up, all the way up, don't bend at the knees, see if you can bring them up 90 degree, exhale, bring them down to 10 degree, means few inches away from the floor. Third time, inhale fully and very slowly, inch by inch, bring them down. Last few inches, make sure no crash landing, just inch by inch and all the ground. Now lay down in a Shavasana for few seconds while I set up the Yoga Nidra audio. But before you go into Yoga Nidra audio, everybody have to do Matsyasana, keeping the trunk up, and top of the head will go on the floor and look the backward. And if you want to cover yourself, just try to bring the blanket nearby, turn the lights down, let's get ready for Yoga Nidra. So as soon as we complete the Matsyasana, we should lay down into the Shavasana pose for Yoga Nidra. So few more seconds and then just follow the instructions and do any final movements. So during the Yoga Nidra, no need to move at all, zero movement, no movement other than the breathing. Okay, get into the Shavasana now, starting the audio.
बॉडी को बिल्कुल सीधा रखना है, शरीर बिल्कुल सीधा रहे, दोनों पैरों के बीच बिल्कुल नॉर्मल डिस्टेंस रखे, एक फुट या डेढ़ फीट का अंतर, दोनों हाथ दोनों साइड में रखें और हथेलियां खुली हुई ऊपर की ओर, और बड़े आराम से लेटें। शरीर की सारी जो बेकार की हिलचाल हो अगर, तो उसे समाप्त कर दें और शरीर को परफेक्टली सेट कर लें। अब एक गहरी सांस लें और उसे छोड़ते हुए धीरे से अपनी आंखें बंद करें। अपना ध्यान सांस के चलने पर रखें। बिल्कुल स्वाभाविक रूप से सांस चलेगी, आपका ध्यान सांस के चलने पर है। जब आप सांस ले रहे हैं और जब सांस बाहर निकल रही है, उस वक्त पेट, चेस्ट और कंधों में जो मूवमेंट्स हो रहे हैं उनका अनुभव करें। बाहर निकलने वाली हर सांस के साथ आपका शरीर धीरे धीरे शिथिल और शांत होता जा रहा है। अब मैं जिस अंग का, जिस हिस्से का नाम कहूंगा, आप अपना ध्यान वहां पर ले जाएं। मैं जिस अंग का नाम कहूंगा, आप अपना ध्यान वहां पर ले जाएं। दाएं पैर का पंजा, उंगलियां, अंगूठा, दाएं पैर की पिंडली, घुटना और घुटने से लेकर कमर तक आपका ध्यान पूरे दाएं पैर पर रखें। अब जब आप एक गहरी सांस लेकर छोड़ेंगे तो अपने दाएं पैर में भरपूर आराम पाएंगे। दाएं पैर में जो आराम महसूस हो रहा है उसका अनुभव करें। पूरे पैर में आराम है, मानो पूरा पैर नींद में हो। अब अपना ध्यान बाएं पैर के तलवे पर ले जाएं। बाएं पैर का तलवा, पंजा, उंगलियां, अंगूठा, बाएं पैर की पिंडली, घुटना और घुटने से लेकर कमर तक पूरा बायां पैर इस वक्त आपके ध्यान में है। आप अपने पूरे बाएं पैर का अनुभव कर रहे हैं। अब जब आप एक गहरी सांस लेकर छोड़ेंगे तो पाएंगे कि पूरे बाएं पैर में आराम है। पूरे पैर में आराम, गहरा आराम, और पूरा पैर नींद में हो। अब अपना ध्यान एक साथ दोनों पैरों पर ले जाएं। दोनों पैरों का एक साथ अनुभव। दोनों पैर गहरे आराम में हैं, अनुभव करें। दोनों पैर निद्रा का मनो अनुभव कर रहे हों। अब मैं जिस हिस्से का नाम लूंगा आप अपना ध्यान वहां पर ले जाएंगे। कमर, हिप्स, पेट, सीना, पीठ, हर जगह पे ध्यान ले जाएं। कमर, हिप्स, पेट, सीना, पीठ। और अब एक गहरी सांस लेकर जब आप छोड़ेंगे तो पाएंगे कि ये हर जगह पे गहरा आराम है, गहरा आराम। अब अपना ध्यान अपने दाएं हाथ पर ले जाएं। कंधे से लेकर उंगलियों तक पूरा दाया हाथ, जाने के दाएं हाथ में क्या हो रहा है अनुभव करें। और एक गहरी सांस लेकर के जैसे ही छोड़ेंगे आप तो पूरे हाथ में आराम पाएंगे, अनुभव करें। दाएं हाथ में गहरा आराम है, मन पूरा हाथ नींद में हो। अब अपना ध्यान बाएं हाथ की ओर ले जाएं और बाएं हाथ का अनुभव करें। कंधे से लेकर उंगलियों तक पूरा बायां हाथ, जाने कि वहां पर क्या हो रहा है। और अब जब आप एक गहरी सांस लेकर छोड़ेंगे तो पाएंगे कि पूरा बायां हाथ गहरे आराम में है, निद्रा में है। अब एक साथ दोनों हाथों का अनुभव करें। दोनों हाथ एक साथ एक गहरी सांस लेकर के छोड़े और दोनों हाथों में आराम पाए, गहरा आराम। अब जिस अंग का मैं नाम कहूंगा आप अपना ध्यान वहां पर ले जाएंगे। गर्दन, जबड़े, गाल, होंठ, नाक, आंखें, कान, कपाल, सिर का ऊपरी हिस्सा, जाने के वहां पर क्या हो रहा है। गर्दन, जबड़े, गाल, होंठ, नाक, आंखें, कान, कपाल, सिर का ऊपरी हिस्सा। एक गहरी सांस लेकर के छोड़ेंगे ये सब गहरे आराम में चला जाएगा, अनुभव करें। फिर से एक गहरी सांस लें और उसको छोड़ते हुए पूरे शरीर का एक साथ अनुभव करें। पूरा शरीर गहरे आराम में है, गहरी नींद, पूरा शरीर गहरी नींद की अवस्था में है, मगर आप जागरूक है इस वक्त। यू आर कॉन्शियस, आप अलर्ट हैं, और इस शरीर की, पूरे शरीर के कण कण की गहरी नींद के साक्षी बने हुए हैं। अनुभव करें। पूरे शरीर में, कण कण में जो गहरे आराम का अनुभव हो रहा है, उस अनुभव में रहें। अब मैं 1 से 5 की गिनती करूंगा। जब 5 कहूंगा, आप स्वस्थ होंगे, फ्रेश और तरोताजा होंगे। अब मैं 1 से 5 की गिनती करूंगा। जब मैं 5 कहूंगा, आप स्वस्थ होंगे, फ्रेश तरोताजा होंगे। 1, 2, 3, 5 की गिनती पर आप फ्रेश होंगे, स्वस्थ होंगे। 4, 5।
Okay, extend both the hands over the body and bring them back. Give body a big good stretch. Fold at the knees and turn body toward the right side. At least 2 to 3 normal breath. And with both help with both the palms, bring the body up back to sitting posture. Rub the palms against each other. Generate the heat. Place them over the eyes and face. Massage the eyelids. Open and close eyes in darkness under the palms. Slide the hand down. Very slowly open the eyes. પ્લેયરની અંદર બંને ફાઇલ હતી, એક પૂરી થઈ એટલે સીધું બીજી ચાલુ થઈ ગઈ. હા, 2-3 જણા તો ઊભા થઈ ગયા હતા સૂર્ય નમસ્કાર કરવા. એ તો ઊંઘમાં કરતા છે, મને લાગે રેકોર્ડિંગ વાગ્યા ભેગું હવે તો. ઓકે, સો લેટ્સ સિટ ઇન એની ક્રોસ લેગ પોસ્ચર. સ્વસ્તિકાસન, સુખાસન, સિદ્ધાસન. લેટ્સ ડુ કુલિંગ ડાઉન પ્રાણાયામ, ચંદ્ર નાડી પ્રાણાયામ, હેન્ડ ઇન વિષ્ણુ મુદ્રા. Inhale and exhale from left side only, left and left. Deeply inhale from left, deeply exhale from left. Sit straight, shoulders relaxed. You can close the eyes. Okay, let's do complete it when you breathe out from the left. Next we'll do Bhramari Pranayama, hands in a Sanmukhi Mudra. We'll do 3 Bhramari Pranayama, and I hope everyone, you guys know what is the Bhramari Pranayama. And after we done 3, then just keep the palms open, tilt the head slightly up, close the eyes, still the body, and try to focus into the third eye between the eyebrows. So let's do 3 Bhramari Pranayama.
Okay. Come back. Let's do Anulom Vilom Pranayama for just 1 minute. And then we're going to talk about Holi something. So we don't want to run out our session so long. So hand in Vishnu Mudra, roll first 2 fingers into root of thumb. Inhale from left, exhale from right. Inhale from right and exhale from left. Alternate breathing, left to right to left. You can chant Gayatri Mantra or any other mantra of your choice. The reason I'm saying Gayatri Mantra because you can make into the 4 pieces very easily. And inhale, exhale can be coordinated properly. Other hands can be in Vayu Mudra. Conclude when you breathe out from left. So, happy Holi to everybody. અને હોલી વિશે કોઈને કઈ બે શબ્દો કહેવા હોય તો is open to audience. Yes, Vandanaben.
Happy Holi, Bakul Bhai. Happy Holi, everyone.
Yes, happy Holi. શું કહેવા માંગો છો હોલી વિશે? કે તમે ખાલી હેપી હોલી કહેવા આવ્યા હતા, મારે એ બે શબ્દ નહોતા કહેવા, બે શબ્દ તમે ઓલા જેવું કર્યું, મને ધક્કો કોને માર્યો? મેં તો કીધું લ્યા હું તો હેપી થયો, વંદના બેન જે નવા નવા જોઈન્ટ થયા છે ને બોલવા આવ્યા. ઓકે, હું મ્યુટ કરું છું તમને. એનીબડી લાઈક Holika, Dahan, what is the significance? Anyone? I think our story goes to Dhruv, right? Dhruv ne? Prahlad ne, sorry. Prahlad ne aakhi conspiracy kare hoy, right? Ke ene Holika ene leine perama besvani hoy. અને એને એને પેલું ફાયર પ્રૂફ જેકેટ પહેરેલું હોય કે કપડું જે કાંઈ હોય એ, અને એવી રીતનું આખી કન્સ્પિરસી હતી અને થયું આખું જુદું. અને એ સિવાયની હોલી એટલે મેઇન તો આપણો ફેસ્ટિવલ ઓફ કલર, કે બધા લોકો જે એકાબીજાથી આમ દૂર દૂર ભાગતા હોય ને એ બધા, આમ હોલીનો તહેવાર આવે એટલે ઓટોમેટિક આપણે મેન્ટલી જ આપણે કોઈક નકર સેજે આમ કંઈક હળી કરવા જાય તો આપણે તરત આપણો મગજ હટી જતો હોય, રાઈટ? એને બદલે હોળી એવો તહેવાર છે કે તમે કોઈને કલર નાખો આ છે કરો તો બધા હેપી, તો હેપી થાય બધા એમ. એટલે એક એક કોન્સેપ્ટ એવો છે મને લાગે છે કે ફેસ્ટિવલ ઓફ કલરનો, કે પીપલ કમ્સ ટુગેધર એન્ડ એન્જોય ટુગેધર. ઓકે, આઈ જસ્ટ સ્ટાર્ટેડ ધ પોઈન્ટ અપ, સો નાવ અપ ટુ ધ ઓડિયન્સ, ડોન્ટ જસ્ટ સે હેપી હોલી. થેન્ક યુ વંદનાબેન. વંદનાબેનને વંદન છે. વંદના બેન આપણા કેનેડાથી જોઈન્ટ થયા છે હમણાં એક જ વીકથી, તો
સેલિબ્રેશન ઓફ સ્પ્રિંગ આફ્ટર વિન્ટર, ડાર્ક મંથ્સ ઓફ વિન્ટર, પીપલ સ્ટેઝ ઇન હાઉસ એન્ડ ધે ગેટ એન ઓપોર્ચ્યુનિટી ટુ કમ આઉટ એન્ડ એન્જોય ધ વેધર.
યસ, ધેટ્સ અનધર વે. યસ, ધેર આર ફ્યુ થિંગ્સ. ઓકે, આઈ સી વન હેન્ડ રેઝ, ગો હેડ. ઓ, એ તો અમારે આપણે, હા, ઓકે, કૃષ્ણાબેન બોલી જાવ પછી વાત કરું.
કલર વાળું હોય, વ્હાઈટ ને બ્લેક ઓછું ગમે, કલર કલર વાળું બધાને સાદી સીધી ભાષામાં કહીએ તો સરસ મજાનું હોય તો ગમે ને બધાને, એમ જીવને એવું જ જીવવું જોઈએ કલરફુલ, અને થાળી કલરફુલ જ જમવી જોઈએ.
ઓકે, એટલે મોહન થાળ બી આવવો જોઈએ, મરચું બી આવવું જોઈએ, છાસ બધું બધા કલર આવવા જોઈએ. ગુડ. યા તો હું એ કેવા જતો હતો. ઓકે, પેલા આપણે હોળીનું પતાવી દઈએ. Anybody else? No, thank you, Krishna. That was good. So, Festival of Colors. Yes, that's another name, right? So, Kusum Ben unmute thiya se, bolo. Okay, unmute thiya, atle me kidu. Okay.
Bakul bhai.
Haan, Shruti Ben, tamaro video on karo ne? Jai to.
વિડિયો ઓન કરવો પડશે. ઓકે,
નહીતર કોક નેમ તક આકાશવાણી થઈ એવું લાગે ને પાછું.
મે મારું મોડું અરીસામાં જોયું નથી સવારે, એટલે વાંધો નહીં.
અમે કહી દે.
એક્ચ્યુઅલી મારામાં જે સેટિંગ થી જોઈન થઈ છું ને એમાં થતો નથી. મારે ખાલી એક જ સેન્ટેન્સ કહેવું છે.
ધેટ્સ ઓકે, કન્ટિન્યુ વિથ યોર
સો જેવી રીતે આપણે હોળીમાં હોલિકા દહનનું જે મહત્વ છે એમાં એક મેસેજ એવો લેવો જોઈએ કે દરેક માનવના મનમાં અને સમાજમાં પણ જે અસત્વૃત્તિ છે એને પણ આ બાળનારો ઉત્સવ છે. એટલે આપણા માનસિક અને સમાજની વૃત્તિના અસત્વૃત્તિ અસત તત્વો છે એને આ દિવસે બાળવાનો પ્રયત્ન કરીએ.
Great. So means all the negativity, all the negative emotions, all the negativities, we will just try to fire it up. Great. Awesome. Thank you, Shruti Ben. Now, એટલા માટે મેં કીધું કે વિડીયો ઓન હોય તો બધા સામે બધા સારું લાગે એમ, પણ વાંધો નહીં, ટેકનિકલ ઇશ્યુ હોય એટલે ધેર ઇઝ નો પ્રોબ્લેમ. ગુડ.
કે મારું ડિફોલ્ટ સેટિંગ છે મારા ક્રોમબુક માં, ઇટ ડઝન્ટ connect to audio, sorry, video, sorry.
That's okay. Anyone else? I see someone has a kesuda in a background. Ma. Okay. Yeah, to pachi apne Mahamrityunjay boli ne. Oh, Smita Ben, you...
Yeah, just have, yeah. Happy Holi to everyone. And from the lecture of the Swamiji who was here 2 weeks ago, he also said that any kind of negative emotions or negativity you have towards anyone of the past, let it burn. Past is a history and in a future is a mystery. So live in the present and enjoy the day of Holi with positive, vibrant energy.
Thank you so much. Great. Awesome. It's very nice word, and now this is perfect way, because all of these our mentors on the mental mentors, they are teaching that if we throw out the negativity, make some room, then automatically
positive comes in.
Positivity. Yes, perfect. Yeah, anyone else? કોઈને દુહો બોલો. અમે તો એવું કરતા નાના હતા ને ત્યારે નદીએ જતા, દરેક ગામમાં નદી તો લગભગ હોય જ, અને ત્યાં હોલિકા દહન નદીમાં થતી, સરસ મજાનું મોટું આખું, અને બધા પહોંચી ગયા હોય આખું ગામ, ત્યાં ડાર્ક થઈ ગયું હોય નાઇટ ટાઈમે, અને પછી એ હોલીનું બધું પતે પછી ખબર હોય તો બધા દોડતા દોડતા આવે ને હોલીને કૂદીને પેલી બાજુ જાય ને આમ થાય ને અંદર શ્રીફળ મૂકેલા હોય ને જે વરઘોડિયા હોય એ હોલીને ફરતા પ્રદક્ષિણા કરે ને એ બધું પતે, ત્યાર પછી દુહાનો પ્રોગ્રામ ચાલુ થાય. કોઈ નદીમાં પેલી બાજુ બેઠા હોય, કોઈ પેલી બાજુ બેઠા હોય, અંધારામાં ખબર ન પડે કોણ દુહા બોલે, એક દુહો ત્યાંથી આવે, એક દુહો પેલી બાજુથી આવે, અલગ 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 જગ્યાએથી દુહાની રમઝટ બોલતી હોય. તો આપણે એવું કરીએ, બીકોઝ અવર એકચ્યુઅલ હોલી સેલિબ્રેશન્સ કે આપણું એન્યુઅલ કે આવતા સેટરડે છે, એ સેશનમાં આપણે થોડું દુહાને ઇન્વોલ્વ કરશું 2-5 મિનિટ. એવું કંઈક એવો થીમ કરીએ કે આપણે બધા નદીમાં બેઠા છીએ અને આપણે બધા હોલિકા એ બધું કરીને પછી આપણે દુહા બોલીએ છીએ. પરફેક્ટ.
ગ્રેટ ગ્રેટ.
યપ.
ઓલરાઇટ. હેવ અ વન્ડરફુલ ડે એવરીવન.
ગ્રેટ. થેન્ક યુ. લેટ્સ કન્ટિન્યુ વિથ અવર ક્લોઝિંગ પ્રોસેસ. Three Mahamrityunjay Mantra followed by short meditation. During meditation, keep awareness at the crown chakra, the top of the head. Everybody together. Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukameva Bandhanat Mrutyor Mukshiyamavrutat Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukameva Bandhanat Mrutyor Mukshiyamavrutat Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukameva Bandhanat Mrutyor Mukshiyamavrutat Chate Purnasya Purnamataya Purnameva Vasishyate Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina Sarve Santu Niramaya Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu Ma Kachit Dukha Bhad Bhavet Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Rub the palms against each other. Place them over the eyes and face. Cross the fingers over the forehead. Bring the palms over the eyes. Open and close eyes a few times. Massage the eyelids. Slowly slide the hands down. Open the eyes. Place hands over the head, neck, shoulders, hands, trunk, and the legs. Jai Shri Krishna. And that concludes the session. And everybody, happy Holi. Enjoy the day.
Happy Holi Bakul Bhai, and tame met patharvanu kidu enu ek